Cat Simp TV. Hey everybody, Cat Simp TV, and let's see what's behind door number 3.
In this episode, we discuss the famous Monty Hall problem, its seemingly paradoxical solution, and a formal proof using probability theory. But first, please do subscribe to this channel for more content coming out regularly, and please consider supporting us via Patreon or Ko-Fi. Links in the description below. The Monty Hall problem is named for Monty Hall, the longtime host of the show Let's Make a Deal. It involves an abstraction of a particular game on the show where a contestant attempts to find a prize behind one of several doors. In the formal version of the problem, there are 3 doors. A prize, usually a card, is randomly hidden behind one of the doors, while the other 2 doors have goats. The game starts with the player choosing door 1. The host then opens one of the other doors, say door 3, to reveal a goat. The player is then given the option to stick with door 1 or change to door 2. Given that there are only 2 doors now, one might intuitively think that there is a 50-50 chance of getting the car with either sticking to the original choice of door 1 or picking the remaining door 2. But in fact, that is not the case.
But before we explain why, let's go over some of the observations and assumptions that underpin this problem.
First, the host always chooses a door different from the one chosen by the player. Second, the host always chooses a door with a goat. Finally, the prizes are not shuffled between door selections. This last point is the most important, as it implies that the selections are not independent events like flipping coins or rolling dice, but rather a single event. With that in mind, let us look closer at the probabilities. There is a 1/3 probability that door 1, the door chosen by the player, has the car. The remaining 2 doors have a 2/3 probability that the car is behind one of them. When Monty opens door 3 to reveal the goat, nothing has changed about these 2 probabilities. But we have more information about door 3. We now know that its probability is 0, but the probability of door 1 having the car remains at 1/3. This leaves the probability of door 2 having the car at 2/3. This is a surprising result. If the contestant sticks with her first choice, she has a 1/3 chance of getting the car. But if she switches to door 2, her chances go up to 2/3. This result, that switching leads to the desired prize 2 out of 3 times, confounds our intuition that the odds between the 2 doors should be 50-50. Indeed, when columnist Marilyn Vos Savant stated the correct answer in her Parade magazine column in the 1990s, she was inundated with angry letters denouncing her, including from supposed mathematics PhDs who insisted that the answer had to be 50-50, even resorting to some tired tropes about women and mathematics.
But 2/3 is the correct probability of winning by switching, and we are going to demonstrate this using both a simulation and a mathematical proof.
We put together a short Python program that simulates the Monty Hall problem, with the player using the strategy of always sticking with the original choice or always switching. We then log whether they successfully get the prize in each case and aggregate the results. Here are the results for running each program 10,000 times. We see that the number of wins when the player switches grows faster than the number of wins when the player sticks to the original choice, about twice as fast. And looking at the totals, we see that approximately 2/3 of the wins are from the program where the player switches. We can also formally prove the result using Bayes' theorem. Bayes' theorem describes the probability of an event when connected to another event or condition. It consists of a posterior, the probability of an event A occurring given another event B, the prior, or the probability of event A occurring before you know anything about B, the likelihood, the probability event B occurs if event A occurs, and finally a normalizing factor based on event B. So let's go back to our scenario. The contestant chooses door 1. Monty chooses door 3 and reveals the goat, so now the car is either behind door 1 or door 2. This is event A and has 2 possible outcomes to compute. First, let's look at the priors. At the outset, the probability that the car is behind door number 1 is 1/3. Similarly, the probability that the car is behind door number 2 is also 1/3. So now let's look at the likelihood term. If the car is behind door number 1, Monty can pick either door 2 or door 3. So the likelihood that he picks door 3 is 1/2. However, if the car is behind door number 2, Monty must pick door 3, so the likelihood is 1. So looking at the numerators for the Bayes formulas, we get 1/6 for the case where the car is behind door number 1, and 1/3 for the case where the car is behind door number 2. The denominator, or normalizing constant, is simply the sum of the two numerator values, given that our two outcomes don't overlap. Finally, we can calculate the posteriors. For the car behind door number 1, we have 1/6 over 1/2, or 1/3. Now for the case where the car is behind door number 2, we have 1/3 over 1/2, or 2/3. Thus, we have a 2/3 chance of finding the car if we switch to door 2, versus only a 1/3 chance if we stick with door 1. I find it fascinating that the answer can be so at odds with our intuition, but this is part of the beauty of mathematics. Do you have any thoughts on the Monty Hall problem, or other non-intuitive results in probability or mathematics? Please let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Check out more at www.catsynth.com. And please subscribe to CatSynth TV.